star drive and radiation. Now comes one of the funny parts. These are the nucleons, like this, three quarks each. Some have one sticking out a bit, which are the protons. But that shape, see the shape, you recognize it, turning around all kinds of directions, depending on the structure of the matter, the crystals. Now I'm going to watch radiation. This is a helium core, and this is exactly the way it looks. You see these two? When it spins fast, they are stretched out. But when it's, the helium core itself goes fast, about the speed of light, it comes to a standstill, pulling those two electrons in. So it looks like a core, but it's still a complete helium atom. Let me show you a helium atom like you have never seen before. Things nobody knows anything about, not even CERN, not even NASA knows how these things look like. Let me show you one. There it is, helium. This is 4 helium. Recognize it? Recognize the nucleons? 1, 2, 3, 4. Neutron, neutron. Proton, proton. And you know what drives them? Let me show you. This is 6 lithium. Again, absolutely new, never seen on this planet before how things work like this. It also has those two spinning around each of its members. This is 1. You recognize it? This blue, 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 blue. This thing is a crystal and can become a structure like steel. It's metal, helium, lithium and metal. It can form a structure. But these are still rotating and they create the gravitational force and some magnetic force, but the gravitational. So, again, real helium driven by electrons. At a normal pace, we call them gravitons, they hit it, and that makes it turn. And helium has special properties. It can climb out of a glass when it's liquid. Why? Well, as you can see, these things, well, they stick out a little less than this, but you get the idea. And glass might seem slick, but it isn't. It's very coarse. So it can climb out of a glass, and it's propelled by gravitons. So this is a little perpetual motion machine. Helium. Helium core flies into a concrete wall. There you go, that's your core. It gets stuck very soon because of the density. We get neutron decay. I'll address that further on. Neutron decay and helium alpha. And one times speed of light, just an estimate. This mass is 24 gravitons. Go back to helium again. 24 gravitons. Why? 4 times 6. 6, 6, 6, 6. 4 times 6, 24. That's the exact mass of helium. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. I'm smarter than them. Then we got the neutrons. Here's your neutron. It flies in, but it's smaller, so it gets a little bit further, but it stops anyway. Then we got beta radiation, electron, and look, 3C, not 2C, I made 3C, because it goes faster. If it was 2C, we wouldn't notice it, because it would be a stupid graviton. So it penetrates the concrete wall, exchanges energy with the rotating quarks, and since 2 is known speed of those things, it slows down itself. So instead of 3C, it becomes 2.5C and 2C. And although it can travel further than that until it gets exchanged by, how you call it? Right, cradle of Newton. Get the fuck. Cradle of Newton, right? That's here. There it stops. But it moves on, the impulse moves on, And we don't see it move on because 3C, 2.5C, 2C. At this point, it goes at a normal rate. And it isn't an electron anymore. It's not an electron. Now it's a graviton. So it appears it goes to here, an electron, but it goes far deeper and the impulse moves on endlessly about, just about endlessly. Then we go to a smaller particle and people say, well, it's not a particle, it's a wave. Fuck that, it's not a wave, we know that. We have a neutrino, gamma, 2 times the speed of light, that's normal for a graviton, moves, and this little pearl on top is this. So if it moves at 2 times the speed of light, but it has a faster spin, we recognize it as gamma radiation because it goes faster. And again, it exchanges energy. And at some point, it has to change places. It changes places, those two. So when that happens, right there, it changes places. And this one is tainted. This one is the one who goes very fast. Then it stops. And it gives energy to him. Or some other graviton moves out. But that's why a neutrino stops here. That's why gamma radiation stops there. Because its carrier stops.